Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the next topic of second chapter, that is the force and laws of motion of class 9. In this free topic, we are going to discuss the Aristotle fallacy and Galileo's remedy. In previous topic, we have discussed about the what is force, what are the effect of forces, what are the type of forces, and the unbalanced force, balanced force, contact force, non-contact force. Now today we are going to discuss about the Aristotle's fallacy and Galileo's remedy. As we know that we have studied the effect of force. That effect of force says that whenever we want to keep any object in motion, we need force. That's in the beginning time, this Aristotle was a great philosopher, and he gave right in the philosophy that whenever we want to keep any object in motion, we need force. We have to apply force over that very object, then the object will remain in motion, otherwise it will stop. Because at that time, we do not have any idea regarding to the friction. So, whenever this any object, suppose that if I draw this chalk at any surface, then this chalk will cover some distance and finally will come in rest. If we take a toy car and if I give a key, if I rotate the spring of that very toy car, it will cover some distance and finally it will come in rest. Another example is what if we shoot an arrow from a bow. Finally what happens, this arrow will cover some distance and finally will come in rest. Then Aristotle come to the final decision that this external force is required to keep body in motion, and this is the fallacy of Aristotle. It becomes failure. This law, this rule, this theory become failure after Galileo's experiment. When Galileo came in exist, then he wanted to show that this external force does not require to keep any body in motion. Suppose that if we want to throw any object, then that object will come in rest after covering some distance, because we know that we have studied that in class 8 about the friction. That friction is what? Friction is a type of force, and that always work opposite to the direction of motion. So here we see that when this Galileo came in exist, then he wanted to check whether this external force is essential to keep any body in motion. So first he demonstrate with this two experiment. In first experiment, he take a base, and in this very base, when he draw a ball on an inclined surface, then finally he observed that in this a speed increases or velocity increases. When any object dropped from certain height, when it is coming downward, its velocity increases. So here we see that when we drop any object, then its velocity increases, so its motion increases. In the second experiment, we take a base, same base, but at this time we throw the object in upward direction. Finally we observe that its speed or velocity decreases this time. Its velocity or speed decreases with time, and finally the ball will come in rest. But in the third experiment, in the third time, when we take a horizontal surface and when we roll the ball, then we observe that this ball cover a long distance. This time ball cover a long distance and keep on moving. So once again he do the next experiment, and he want to check it whether this external force is really essential to keep any body in motion. So here he observed that at different angle and different time this force is different, so there is something that opposes the motion of the body, or at another time we do not need the external force to keep the body in motion. So in the next experiment, he take a hemisphere, and inside that very hemisphere, so this is a hemisphere, and in this very hemisphere, when he drop a ball, then he observe that this ball reach to the another side and up to the same height. Finally, this ball does not come in rest and once again it returns to the same height. It means this ball keep on moving up and down, just in the oscillation motion. This side up, finally we come and this side up. When you take a smooth hemisphere, then you observe that this ball keep on moving for a long time. This time ball does not stop, but this time when we draw, finally this ball will come in rest. When we throw this ball, finally we call this ball will come in rest, but at this time this ball does not come in rest. In the second experiment, we take this very hemisphere, but at this time this depth of the hemisphere decreases and the length increases. Then we observe that this time this ball will cover a longer distance to come up to that height. Then finally, slowly and slowly, we start decreasing the another side. Suppose that this is the side A and this is the side B. So slowly and slowly, when we decreasing the side B, then in each and every step of the decreasement of this another side, he observed that this ball cover a longer distance. Finally, and the last in the C, he take the hemisphere and the another side of hemisphere, totally convert or totally change it in the horizontal surface, horizontal smooth surface. Then when we drop the ball, this ball keep on moving before coming rest. Then he conclude that no, if the ball will in uniform motion, if the body is moving in uniform motion, then there is not any external force are required over the object to keep the body in motion. So this is the Aristotle fallacy and Galileo's remedy. Aristotle fallacy, finally the conclusion is what? Aristotle says that to keep on moving we need external force, but Galileo says that no, if there is not any change in the velocity, if there is not any change in the speed of the body, then body will remain in the same velocity. It means there is not an external force that required over the object and the body will keep on moving without bringing rest or without coming rest. Now on the conclusion of the Galileo's remedies, finally Newton's came in exist, and this time Newton gave three laws of the motion, that is the first law of motion, second law of motion and third law of motion. Now we are going to discuss about the what are the laws of motion or what are the Newton's law of motion. Okay, now let's see.